How are we doing, Sydney FC members? Ryan McGowan here from quarantine. Gonna answer your questions for the next, well, however long it takes me to go through since I've not got much else to do. Surviving here in quarantine just now. I'm about halfway through. So I'm looking forward to joining up with the boys and let's get ripped into some of these questions. Got a question from Kate. Asking, are you able to get some vitamin D each day? In lockdown, we're not allowed to. Literally not allowed out my room. So I've been spending pretty much 24/7 in the room. You don't even get room card to go into the hallway. So yeah, just been stuck in this room for the last 7 or 8 days now, and I get out on the 30th. So I can join up with the boys on the 30th. From Adrian, favorite thing to do outside of football? Probably spending time with friends and family. Like most of us, have spent a lot of my career traveling around and being in hotels and being in different places. So in my downtime, I like to spend some time with friends and family and yeah, just enjoy what everyone else does, going out for dinner, a few things like that. Where else? Angus has asked, where did you come back from? Been in the UK. So I'm pretty much, even though I'm an Aussie, I'm pretty much based in Scotland, in Edinburgh. That's where my home is, so kids are, wife. So I spend most of my time in the UK when I'm not playing football. So that's where I've come from. Ivan asked, do you think Sydney FC will win the grand final? Yeah, well, I'm kind of quietly confident. We have to obviously finish off the season with the remaining games, and then it will go to final series. So we need to make sure that the last couple of games that we're playing well and wrap up the Premier's plate first, and then focus on the championship. But that's definitely one of our goals. You know, we set out at the start of the season was to go back to back, and you know, I think we've started off well. But you know, with the final series, you need to make sure we're on the ball and make sure first and foremost we make the grand final, and then hopefully win it when it does come. What have we got here? Max Bagatelle. Sorry if that's pronounced wrong. How is it when you played Motherwell when you're in Scotland as they are your team? Yeah, it's well, there you are now. You just popped up. Big Max. Yeah. You know, I enjoyed it. It's a good little good park at Fir Park, got good fans. Had a really successful season last year. Well, the season just finished. So your question just now that you've asked who would win, Sydney FC or Motherwell, I'd be slightly biased. I think we would win. But, yeah, you know, it's quite difficult when people ask to compare different leagues. But, you know, we definitely got players that would play for Motherwell and, you know, hopefully get the win. See a few boys popping up. A few of my mates popping up. Keep it PG, boys. Yep. Yeah. Ibby's asked, how would you compare the competition of the Scottish League and the A-League? Yeah, like I just touched on, you know, they're two totally different leagues with totally different playing styles, different players, different budgets, you know, but I definitely think, you know, Sydney FC, Melbourne Victory, Wellington this season, you know, we're three very good teams that would do well in Scotland and perform well. But also at the same time, you know, there's teams in Scotland, Celtic, Rangers, Motherwell for one last season who also have good teams. And, you know, if they were to play in the A-League would definitely be challenges up at the top and have a chance of winning the championship. But, yeah, it's one of those questions that it's kind of a bit hypothetical because it's never really going to happen. But, yeah, both bring different styles and different play, and you know, I've enjoyed my time in both Scotland and in Australia so far. Cameron, why are you using a PKM in your COD loadout? Well, it's just my favourite gun. Anyone that plays Call of Duty, I'm a bit of a geek, so I've been smashing that the last 7 or 8 days and not been too successful with it, but yeah, that's just my gun. It's got 200 odd bullets, so I make sure that I don't miss or I don't get stuck reloading. And yeah, probably enjoy Call of Duty a lot more than I should do at the age of 30. Benny Warland, kid from Gawler, good Adelaide boy. He asked, what website have you been used the most since you arrived in your hotel? That's a bit of a cheeky question there, Benny boy. But yeah, probably just Smarterbase, putting in all my data from my weights programs and my running programs. So yeah, just keeping the Sydney coaching staff up to date on what I've been doing. A couple of questions from the members. Charlie from Paddington, what was the UK like compared to Australia during lockdown? Yeah, there's two different styles and different approaches. When I arrived in the UK, it was probably end of March, I think it was. And there was no quarantine or no checks like that. So was able just to wander in and get straight to Edinburgh where I stay, and without too many questions asked. They did have lockdown in terms of going to the shops, which they still do, like pubs and nightclubs, etc., aren't open. So they're still quite strict in terms of that, but not as strict in terms of when you arrive at the airport, straight into a hotel for 2 weeks quarantine. So I do think that's something that they're possibly bringing in, or they have just brought in when I've been coming this way. But yeah, I think a lot of countries are doing it differently, but I think Australia's done really well, and it shows with the amount of cases that we don't have, and the fact that we're allowed fans back into stadiums. So hopefully when we play Wellington, we can have some fans in it, and towards the final series, hopefully a few more. Just got these questions on my phone. Sam from Kensington, what's the best food you've eaten during your hotel stay? So I'm lucky enough that I'm staying at the Marriott, so it's just pure by choice of where we're staying. So we get literally just missed it. So it's a little knock on your door for breakfast, lunch, and dinner, and they'll leave you a meal. So probably the best one, where they had a Greek salad the other day for lunch, which was quite good. They've had some nachos, spaghetti bolognese. So they've been relatively good, but you can also get room service. So if you don't particularly like the meal that they've provided you, you can jump on the phone and order some room service and pay for that. So probably between the spaghetti bolognese is probably the best one that I've had since I've been in the hotel. Chloe from, what did you say? What would you say was the biggest moment of your career and why? I'll split that into two questions. I'll split that into two since we've got plenty of time. I'm going to go that club career or club highlight would probably be my time at Hearts, where I was lucky enough to win the Scottish Cup final and scoring it against our local rivals. So Hearts hadn't won the cup in a few years, so it was a massive moment for myself and the club. And having come through the ranks at Hearts, it was sort of a really good way to give something back to the club, and it's really good memories that I have from my time there. So from a club point of view, that would probably be my highlight, although I did win the Chinese Cup in China, and that was also pretty good to get us into the Asian Champions League. So probably between those two, but I definitely think the Hearts one jumps up. And on an international level, it's probably playing at the World Cup. It's every kid's dream to grow up is to first and foremost play for your country, which I've been lucky enough to do. But to actually play in a World Cup was unbelievable. So that's probably my main career highlight was them. And I've had a few. Obviously, my debut was again in Edinburgh against Scotland, which was the way the stars aligned was really good, because I had some friends and family at that game, and a lot of people at Hearts who had helped me through the 16-17 to get to that stage. So it was it was a really nice moment for myself to have my family there. Mum was there, Dylan was there, so it was good to make my international debut, and then obviously playing in the World Cup was pretty special. Michael Smith, 15-year member. Well done, buddy. How long will it take you to get back onto the pitch and be ready for action? And do you think you'll be able to play the first game? first part of the question was, it shouldn't take too long, to be honest. I've been working pretty hard in the off season that we've had, or the time the last couple of months which we've been off with this whole sort of COVID situation. So I've been keeping myself busy with the running programs that we've been given from our medical team and things like that. So I've been pretty busy in terms of that. So it shouldn't take me too long once I join up with the boys, but you know, I have left it a little bit tight with everything that's been going on. So I'll probably only have about 2.5 weeks before the first game with the boys. So yeah, I'm quietly confident that I'll be available for selection and hopefully get selected and play against Wellington. Just having a little look through the questions that people have been sending in. Harry Vandersack, how you going? Big red dog. Join the young up and coming Sydney youngster there. Another one from John Santo says, when asked, all the boys say you are the funniest in the change room, but is it true? Probably is. It's not much competition, but who is second funniest? Got a few boys that try, but like everyone says, we have a really good group. Enjoy pretty much everyone's company in the team. So be a combination of Luke Bratton, Lafondra, Retre Zulo, sort of the common targets are the ones that are always sort of up to no good, and Ryan Grant, but although he's the fine master, so he's a little bit more serious at training ground, not when you get him out the pub for a couple of gold ones. Hey, Booster. The Barnett, some haircut he's got. Right, there we go. Ryan from, I'm not even going to try that. Which of your teammates would you most enjoy sharing a beer or two with? So, like I just touched on before, we've got a really good group at Sydney. You know, I enjoy everyone's company, and we've had a few good nights out, you know, a couple of away trips and our Christmas party. So we all got to dress up. I went as the Joker. So everyone got to pull a letter out the hat. And whatever letter you got to dress up as that one. So, yeah, obviously got Jay, so I went as the Joker. But we had some pretty good costumes, and we had a good day out in Sydney. You know, sort of just getting away from football and the serious side, the serious stuff that we do every day, and you know, getting sort of closer as a group and enjoying a couple of beers. So, yeah, hopefully we can have a few more celebrations towards the end of the season, once we wrapped everything up. I'm gonna try and go through some of the questions that you're firing in now. Bekaroski, how you doing, buddy? He's asked, who was your idol growing up, Peter McDermott or Daniel Greco? It's a close one. Two great guys, but yeah, it's too hard to pick between those two. Shared a changing room with them when I was young, playing down at Parry Hills Knights in Adelaide. So a couple of great guys there, and good to see you, Becca. Congratulations. Just had a little one. Kevin's wrote, how was it playing in the AFC Champions League for Sydney and for Shandong Luneng? Is it treated differently in China compared to in Australia? Good question. You know, we only got to play a couple of games for Sydney. We're obviously in a very difficult group and sort of halfway through that competition. So, you know, we've got the champions of Japan with Ange, champions of Korea, and then Shanghai and China. So it's a very difficult group, but, you know, one that we feel that, you know, we could have probably done better in the games that we have played in, but one that, you know, we're still confident of getting out of the group. I would probably maybe say in China, it's seen as a massive deal. You know, they put big pressure on the big clubs to get in the Champions League, and then once they are in it, they take it very seriously, and you know, the Chinese Federation helps them out in terms of if they have to travel sort of long distances in it. You know, they make sure that they move the games at the weekend, which maybe, you know, the Aussies could help us a little bit with in terms of the traveling. You know, when we came from, I think Japan, I think we arrived back in Sydney. I think it was a Friday at some point. I mean, we had the game against Central Coast on Sunday, so it's a short turnaround from such a long flight, but you know, it's part and parcel of what we do. So yeah, just get on with it. But hopefully we get to start that competition back up and get a few wins and progress through to the group stage. A few Mexican fans. Caceres. Just looking at some of the questions. David's just asked there, what's it like playing against your brother? Yeah, you know, that was a good experience, obviously, besides the bloody result. You know, having grown up very close. So, you know, it was a good opportunity to play against him, and the way it worked out with obviously him at the Wanderers and me there, it was an opportunity to play in the sort of big derbies, and yeah, it was a good occasion, but obviously we're playing in the same position. We don't really get too close to each other unless it was at a set piece, but yeah, he's got the bragging rights at the minute, obviously with the results this season, but you know, hopefully we can put that right next season and get a couple of wins on the board and yeah, hopefully I have the last laugh winning the Premier's plate and hopefully championship at the end of next month. I think one here, you once nearly moved to Rangers. Tell us about that. Well, that was a long time ago now, getting older. So, yeah, that was 2013 or 2012. Yeah, it was a number of factors why I didn't move there at the time. They just got relegated down to the third division in Scotland, and although they're a massive club with you know, unbelievable fan base, and you know, they're right back up challenging for the title now in Scotland, it was at that time something that I you know, just couldn't see myself doing. I just broke into the national team. We were 18 months away from a World Cup, and I just thought my chances were of making that World Cup squad or playing for Australia was much better being at Hearts. So I just made that decision to stay at Hearts, as difficult as that was. And yeah, on reflection, it was probably the right decision at that time. But yeah, you know, it's good to see them back and competing. And you know, hopefully my old side Hearts can stay in the Premiership and yeah, you know, make the Scottish League better. Tell us about your cross to Timmy. Not too sure what you're talking about. yeah, obviously with the World Cup assist that I like to sometimes bring up if anyone's interested. It's yeah, you know, it was a great moment for me, and one that once I finish and retire, I'll get to tell the grandkids and anyone down the pub when I'm the old man to say that, you know, that was my claim to fame, is that you know, I set up or played a part in the goal that Timmy scored in the World Cup. And you know, that whole day it was just started, you know, the first game I'd come on against Chile, and yeah, second game against Holland was lucky enough to start, and you know, to go 2-1 ahead when Mille scored the penalty was unbelievable. But I think, you know, at the end of the day we did lose that game, and it was disappointing, and yeah, it's probably a what if moment. You know, imagine if we did win that game and go on against Spain, it could be totally different. But yeah, a lot of ifs, buts, and maybes there. So yeah, it was something that I definitely look back on in my career with great highlights. Stuart Miller, must have a few Rangers fans on here. Did you get to go to Ibrox when you're in Scotland? Yeah, obviously played at Ibrox, Parkhead, Easter Road, played at, you know, all the stadiums in Scotland, and thoroughly enjoyed all of them. You know, probably slightly biased in terms of, I think Tynecastle's probably got the best atmosphere, but you know, been to a few old firm games. Lucky enough, Tommy Rogic just sorted me out with a few tickets, so got to go along to a few of those games and experience those highlights and those atmospheres. So yeah, you know, really enjoyed playing at all those big stadiums in front of the fans. And you know, with the way that the situation is just now in Australia, hopefully, you know, we can get more fans into the games leading into the final series, and you know, have a full house might be wishful thinking, but you know, leading into the finals, which will be good. And what everyone, all the players want to do is play in front of you guys and the fans, and hopefully that can happen in the next couple of weeks. Robert's just asked, what do you think of MacArthur Bulls' chances? You know, like any new team coming into the league, it's a bit of the unknown. You know, they've signed a couple of good players. Tom Yorke's gone there, and I think Ante's obviously the coach. So, you know, they've got a sort of big task ahead of getting the whole squad together and sort of starting from scratch. But, you know, it's definitely good from a Sydney point of view. It's kind of another derby that we can look forward to, and a bit of freshness about the league. You know, there's obviously a lot of talk going on about the B-League and, you know, what Australia football needs to do. And I think new teams and a B-League would definitely help the league grow and get more people involved. And that's obviously what we want moving forward. But, yeah, hopefully they don't become too good and knock us off top spot. But, yeah, you know, I think the more teams and the more players, the more people involved in football, the better it will be moving forward. Just going to have a look to see any more questions that's coming through. There's a few questions from the members I'm just trying to bring up. Here's one from Neill Snowden. What is your favourite film actor of all time and why? It's a great question. Maybe say Leonardo DiCaprio. I just really like his movies. I think it's pretty gonna struggle to find a movie that he's not done that's not that good. Wolf of Wall Street is one of my favorites, I guess. I think he did a really good performance in that. But yeah, just like Catch Me If You Can, a lot of his movies, Departed, you know, all of them I really enjoy. So he's probably my favorite actor of all time. Sandra's asked, do you have any plans for after football? I don't particularly have too many at the minute. I've just turned 30, so feel like I've got a few more years left in the old legs. So, yeah, that's something I'll probably think about in the next couple of years. But, not studying anything at the moment. But got a couple of properties that I'm interested in and like doing. So it might be something to do with, you know, real estate or getting away from football. But if I was to stay in football, it would probably be in the grassroots level I'd like to get involved in, with the kids and the younger players in the team, or the younger players in football, I guess, and just trying to set them on the right path. And I think it would be really rewarding, you know, seeing a young player grow from, you know, 12, 13, 14 and have that pure love of the game and making a success in it. So that's probably something that would interest me, you know, coming into my later stages of my career is the younger players that are coming in. There's Benny Water. Benny, you're coming late, mate. I've already answered your question. Big boy from Gawler. Joel Wilkinson has asked, who would you say the best player you've ever defended is? Besides Benny Warland in training, played against a few good players in my time. Neymar in Brazil is obviously one that a lot of people refer to. Got beat 6-0. No one particularly played well that day, and he was unbelievable. So that would probably be, you know, one-off game, probably the best player I've played against. But then we played PSG at the start of the season in pre-season tournament in China. We played against Mbappe, who probably will be the next big superstar of world football, and you could tell from, you know, considering how young he is, how far ahead of everyone he is. I definitely think that he will be one that, you know, in the next 5-6 years will be a player that we'll look back on and say, I played against him. Cavani played that game, and then at the World Cup, you know, some pretty good players that we came up against at the World Cup. So Van Persie, Schneider, Robin, and then Spain had Torres, Iniesta, Xavi, legends of the game. So I've been very fortunate enough to play against some of the big dogs in world football, and Yeah, probably take your pick out of the ones I've just mentioned there. See a few more questions coming in. Joel King, young left back, up and coming left back, bad golfer. How you doing? Just having a look at these questions. I think I've pretty much answered a fair whack of them. If anyone's got a few more coming through, just try and answer as many as I can since I don't have too much else to do. Favorite stadium you've played to play in? Oh, it's a good one. Played in some big stadiums. Probably my favorite, like I touched on a little bit earlier, maybe Tynecastle, just for the atmosphere, and probably played most games there. But yeah, really enjoyed playing at Jubilee at Sydney. Thought it was a really good atmosphere. We had some good games against, you know, the one against earlier against Melbourne City was a really good atmosphere, and a couple of the derbies at Bank West were good atmospheres. So yeah, probably any of those three that we've played at this season have been good. And yeah, we've been disappointing that, you know, the situation with the fans and the whole worldwide pandemic that's going on. It would have been, you know, I was looking forward to the final series and you know, playing in front of some big crowds and hopefully winning some stuff in front of you, which would have been you know, one of the main reasons why I came back. But yeah, you know, hopefully that can get sorted out in the next couple of weeks. What's Benny Wallen? What's your go-to order on Uber Eats? I like Japanese food. I really enjoy Japanese food, so maybe a bit of sushi. But you know, me, Benny, been looking after the body, so I've been trying to stay away from Uber Eats. But yeah, I've ordered in a few bits of sushi now and then. So yeah, probably sushi, a bit of Japanese food, can't go wrong, I don't think. James just wrote, what are you guys going to do differently so you win the next derby? James, we try and win all the derbies, mate. Been trying to win everything. So yeah, just obviously score more goals. You know, I think as much as we probably didn't play, you know, the first game we played really well, but was unfortunate to go behind. Juki scoring a goal, and then it's just one of those games where, you know, we had plenty of chances and just weren't able to capitalize on them. And then second game, a little bit similar. I think Wanderers set up really well, and from a defensive point of view, from their side, you know, had a great game in nullifying us and you know, stopping us scoring. And they got one towards the end. Again, Juki headed to, which was disappointing from a defensive point of view, but and then last game was a deflection. You know, it's one of those ones that's gone straight to Redders and gets a deflection off their boy and loops in. But yeah, you know, it's definitely something next year that we want to win derbies. But I think, you know, if you ask any members or any of the players, if you said, you know, hopefully this season we can finish with the Premier's plate and win the championship, I think that's a lot better than, you know, the Wanderers having won a couple of derby games. So, you know, that's something that we want to sort out next week, but next season, sorry. But yeah, we've got some bigger fish to fry, trying to win the championship. Brooksy's just joined. It's my first senior coach. Hope you're well, mate. Favourite Sydney FC moment so far? Would probably go with the Melbourne City game at home. Obviously, with Ryan Grant being sent off early on in the game, leaving us boys in the trenches, didn't help, and then went behind. So it was a difficult one. But yeah, you know, it was a good team performance, one that we had to grind out, and was you know, a great feeling when Costa bent that one in with his left foot, and the place went wild. And I think it really stamped our you know, sort of dominance on the league in terms of, you know, that was our closest rivals at that time, and probably still are, Melbourne City. And yeah, you know, that was a sort of big win for us in terms of moving forward, and at a good time of the season to really, you know, stretch our legs and put some points in between. I think we were first at the time and they were second, so put a few bit of some points in between us and a bit of breathing space leading into the Champions League, and something that we've stretched on, and hopefully in the coming games can get this Premier's plate wrapped up and look forward to the final series. Let me just have a couple of quick questions. A few more people have wrote in. Got plenty of time, not going anywhere. George just wrote, who smells the worst in the team? Random question. A couple of young guys stink in the changing rooms. So not going to name any names, but just the young teenage boys trying to work out what they're doing with their life, I guess. But yeah, there's no one that really stinks that bad, but a few boys aren't hygienic, but we're teaching them, we're getting them there. Kevin again ask another question. Do you agree with the proposed A-League move to a winter season, and how do you think promotion and relegation would affect the league? Pretty deep question there. I think we sort of need to back ourselves as a football community. You know, I think all you Sydney FC members would have some sort of interest in, if it's either rugby league or AFL, in terms of a team that you support or a team that you to like to watch in the winter seasons. But I think if you had the choice of, you know, I don't really know my NRL too much, but, you know, if you had the choice of going to a Sydney FC game or a West Tigers game, you know, I feel that most Sydney FC fans would pick going to a Sydney game. So, you know, it will be difficult to compete with them in terms of, you know, coverage that we get in the media or newspapers or things like that. But, you know, we probably don't get a huge amount of media time in the summer months when those stuff isn't going on. So, you know, I think we just need to worry about football in terms of what we can affect. And, you know, if we can look at that from a aspect of, you know, we'll get right behind each and every club. You know, there will be some clubs that lose sort of members or fans, social fans that, you know, maybe came along to games in the summer because it was something to do and the weather was nice. But I think if you're interested in football and you like watching Sydney FC, you'll come to games no matter when they are. So, you know, I don't think it will affect the league too much in terms of joining in the winter season. And if you're wanting to do promotion and relegation, then that's probably the best thing to do it. And, you know, I definitely think it would improve the league having promotion and relegation. It just means that there's a little bit more extra onus on every game because, you know, the teams down the bottom are fighting for relegation. You know, if you get relegated, then your chances are that, you know, the club's going to have to make cuts, pays different. And for the B League, it puts a pathway for, you know, a whole another 10 clubs which have 30 players in it. And straight away, that's a lot of players who then have a goal of trying to reach the A League. Gives the A League an opportunity to watch players in the B League. And if you perform well in the B League, there's every chance that players will pick you up and bring you into an A League club, and vice versa. If you drop out of an A League club, you're not dropping, you know, right down to part-time football. You'll be able to drop down to hopefully B League and fill your time in there and, you know, sort of reset your career. So, you know, I definitely think the more teams that are involved and the more teams that have a pathway that they can give kids, adults, aspiring professionals, then the better it is for Australian football. And, you know, you get more fans going to those types of games. And, you know, there's a lot of historically big clubs in Australia, you know, Adelaide City, Campbelltown, you know, from being an Adelaide boy, those two clubs, along with sort of Wollongong, Melbourne Knights, you know, clubs that we've grown up watching in the sort of the old NSL, you know, they would they'd be wanting or fancying their chances of getting in the A-League and really giving it a shake. So, you know, I'm all for it. So, yeah, you know, that's definitely something that I would look at. Another question coming in from any members. Favorite airline flying with is probably Qantas, I guess, or Emirates, one of those two. Pretty random question, but yeah, probably one of those two would be my favorites. Favorite teammate? It's too many. Probably wouldn't pinpoint on one. Between, you know, I've known Ryan Grant, Redders, Bratzy, Zules, Wilco. Known those boys for a long time, so it'd probably be between any one of them. But I get on with most of the boys in the team. You know, they're all good guys and good teammates to have. So yeah, probably any one of those ones. Benny Wall and all the young boys are good. So it's a bit of a cliche, but you know, we've got a really good group there, and I get on with everyone. Right, I think that's, what's that, 35 minutes. Gonna get some dinner. Thanks for all your questions. I'm just gonna give everyone a couple of minutes to see if they put any more questions in. A few people at Sydney are a little bit nervous about me being in charge of the admin page. I think they're worried I'm gonna say anything or do something. Easy, Dave. So I think that's about it. Just going through again. Yeah. Thanks for all your questions, guys. Hope you enjoyed it. Yeah, hopefully we'll see you all at a game and stay safe. First and foremost, stay safe with everything going on, and hopefully the restrictions get to lift and we can see most of you out at games soon enough. So thanks for that, guys, and all the best.